Lurking within the ancient palaces of the jungles of Tarkir, the Sultai brood is, well, brooding. Yeah, the Sultai haven't really established a strong competitive presence yet. Looking at recent tournament results on MTG Goldfish, I began to notice a trend. It's subtle, see if you can spot it. Let's see, we've got Jeskai, Abzan, Jeskai, Jeskai, Abzan, Abzan. Oh, Rabble Red, is that still around? Another Jeskai, something called Demonic Zoo. Oh, it's just another Abzan variant. Abzan, Abzan, Jeskai, Abzan, Jeskai. Hey, Rabble again. Oh, cool, Mardu. Abzan, Jeskai. Ta! And Wizards of the Coast complained Modern didn't have enough diversity of decks? Researching other websites and tournament reports seemed to confirm that, at least as of the making of this video, Sultai hadn't quite found a highly successful archetype. So what to do? I don't want to just take Sultai Delve or Sultai Control and build a budget version of the original that isn't even working anyway. So we're going to do something different, but I hope you'll still find it interesting. Let's use this opportunity for experimentation and trying to discover alternate approaches. So I went down to Anime Imports in Pacifica, California to ask store owner Mike Fields, a hardcore home brewer, to show me a bug of a different direction. And this is what he shared with us. Striking a deal with the Rakshasa, the Sultai have figured out how to let others do the work for them. That's why all of Tarkir knows of the Sultai treasure and wealth. A Sultai treasure and wealth deck takes advantage of Ashiok, much overlooked until recently. And while you steal your opponent's spells, the deck gives you backup with a mix of mid-range and control. Yep, we're in green, so ideally we're gonna have coursers and caryatids. But this deck is going to want to capitalize on their ramp to fuel our forces. Nissa, therefore, is included more for her second ability to untap lands than for her more aggressive first ability. And Kiora joins us as well to combine protection with extra card draw and land drops. The deck has an elegant control package that I'll get to in a moment, but let's cover a bit of the brute force we offer with a Sagu Mauler, and also Garrick, both of which benefit greatly from our acceleration. Since a lot of our control package will rely on Delve, Sidisi is a 2 of as well, and her zombie generation gives us an extra layer of ground forces as we accelerate towards the finish line. But what else can we do with all of this acceleration? What makes this deck different and distinct? Well, I told you the Sultai get others to do the work for them. That's right. We're aiming to use the highly underrated and often overlooked villainous wealth to take advantage of all that extra mana. Along the way, we dive into black with Drown and Sorrow, Bile Blight, and Hero's Downfall, stalling out our opponent's board until we can dig for the answers we need and stealing the rest before they get a chance to cast with Thoughtseize. The mana base is about what you'd expect from Khans of Tarkir at this point. A small sack of gold to buy fetches, scries, and a mana confluence. Finally, the sideboard allows us to fine-tune our control spells. But all of this is going to cost us a small fortune. And if you're choosing to go with a rogue homebrew instead of a sure thing, maybe you don't want to spend all that money. You maybe want to try and capture the essence of the deck without getting captured by the cost. The Sultai might be merciless, but show a little mercy to your wallet with a $100 Sultai treasure budget build, the Nemesis Wave. Nemesis Wave still tries to tap into the key forces of control and acceleration, and relies heavily on cards like Ashiok and Villainous Wealth. These two cards pair together nicely. And to our benefit, although Ashiok has recently shot up in price, we can still afford all three that the deck needs, seeing no downgrade there. In fact, much of the control package can remain the same as well, as our cuts are, of course, going to be in our mana base. The toughest replacements besides Manabase will be the acceleration from Corsair, Caryatid, and Nissa. While this is far from ideal, it is budget, so I'm going to trade out for the embodiment of Spring and Kiora's follower. We can even use embodiment for a strategic block and sack if our opponents have an early board presence. And Nissa is $40 for a reason, there's just no substitute. But I think our best bet is to trade her for a Prophet of Krufix, to add to our mana supply and flash out additional creatures during our opponent's turn. Replacing Thoughtseize with Despise isn't even that bad of a downgrade. We're still getting rid of both creatures and planeswalkers on turn 1 and or 2, preventing everything from those rhinos to those dragons to that mad dragon-obsessed planeswalker. Despise works nice in a heavy creature and heavy planeswalker environment. Most of the rest of our control package is the same, or with only a few minor tweaks. Now, Dig Through Time is too costly to run two of and stay under budget, so unleashed until it drops back down in price, a ticket for a treasure cruise will have to do in place of one of them. Luckily, we can still afford Sidisi and stay within budget, as well as our Sagu Maulers. Finally, I want just a bit more oomph from this deck, so I'm going to run a copy of the Soul of Innistrad, another highly underrated card in my opinion, and thus very affordable. For our mana base, we swap out the temples for the life gain lands. As always, if you've any temples in our colors, fetches, or a mana confluence, even just a few do wonders for the mana base. And our sideboard is largely unchanged. Sometimes, when everyone is playing one of two decks, the best way to break through that environment is to try something new in that environment and unexpected. You can still be merciless as the Sultai are to your opponents, while showing a little mercy to your wallet with a $100 Sultai treasure budget build, such as Nemesis Wave. But maybe Ashiok and Villainous Wealth aren't for you. Well, stay tuned, because we'll finish covering all five of the clans this week. There might even be a few more surprises coming your way. I hope these videos have been helpful to you. You can help me out by remembering to subscribe, like, share, or just by leaving a comment. And remember, you can't play Magic at Target or Walmart, so try and spend that money where you spend your time playing Magic, and that's at your local game store. You're supporting your Magic community.